Dear friends, myself Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, and today we are going to discuss in this video number systems. What are number systems? So as and when number comes in your mind, you think of 1, 2, 3, 4. So what kind of numbers are they? They are called natural numbers. They are natural numbers. And if a number 0 is included to this sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, then it becomes what? Then it becomes whole numbers. So these kind of numbers are whole numbers. And when I introduce negative numbers like -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, then it becomes integers. And about this integer, there is a set called set of rational numbers. Rational numbers. So rational numbers are what? Rational numbers are in the form of P by Q. They are in the form of P by Q. Where P and Q both are what? They are, P and Q are integers. Q should not be what? Q should not be 0. Q should not be 0. Means P and Q, rational numbers will be in the form of P by Q, where Q means denominator should not be 0. This you can experience yourself. Use your calculator and do this practice. Divide 3 by 0. If you divide 3 by 0, then you will find an error. But we will be discussing more on this issue. What is 3 by 0? What is 4 by 0? 5 by 0? What should be this value? So here a basic idea I say you, that this value is not defined and sometimes it is called infinite. So I'll be discussing more on this issue later on, but in this section I can say that rational numbers are in the form of P by Q. They are in the form of P by Q. And where P and Q are what? They are integers. Means P and Q can take these values. These values P and Q can take. But Q should not be what? Q should not be 0. And one more thing you can keep in mind, that P and Q should not have any factor common in them except one. Any factor common in them except one. For example, 4 upon 6, this is a rational number, but it is not written in its simplest form. So to convert it into its simplest form, I should divide the common factor in numerator and denominator, and which is 2. So after dividing this numerator and denominator by 2, it becomes 2 by 3, the simplest form of this 4 by 6 is 2 by 3, and this is a rational number. And this is a rational number because 2 and 3 do not have any common factor between them except 1. So we write like this, that there is no common factor in 2 and 3 except what? 1. Because 2 by 3 can be written as 2 into 1, 3 into 1. Therefore, 1 is common in both. So we write 2, 3 is equal to 1. And if we have 4, 6, then what do we write? 4, 6 is equal to 2. So this is a sort of notation. This is a special notation. We will be discussing in some other videos about these things. But here, what are rational numbers? Rational numbers are in the form of P by Q, where Q is not 0, and P and Q both are integers. So if I write Q as 1, then P upon Q will be what? then P upon Q will be P upon 1. Can I do this? Yes, of course I can do this. Why? Because Q and P should be what? Integers, and Q should not be 0, and other than 0, Q can take any value. So I can put Q is equal to 1 here, and if I put Q is equal to 1, then it becomes what? P. And what is P? P, you can see, P is an integer. Because P and Q both are integers, and if I fix Q is equal to 1, then it becomes P, and P is what? An integer. P is an integer. So P is an integer, therefore all integers are coming under the umbrella of rational numbers. Like natural numbers come under the whole number. Whole numbers come under the this integers. So if I use a word known as set, so natural number is a set, whole number is a set, integer is a set. And if I use another term, subset, so natural number is a subset of this, means natural numbers are elements of whole number, all natural numbers are whole number, all whole numbers are integers, and all integers are what? All integers are, my dear, all integers are rational numbers. And if I discuss more on this issue, rational numbers, so they can be like this, 2.375. What is this? This is a rational number. Why is this a rational number? Because it can be written in the form of 2375 divided by 1000. Of course, you will have to cancel and you will have to keep this number in the simplest form. This is not the simplest form. And 22 by 7. Moreover, let's discuss about this 22 by 7. What kind of number is this? 22 by 7 is what? This is a rational number. Of course, this is a rational number, but we are told, we keep this thing in practice, that pi is not a rational number. Of course, pi is not a rational number. Then what kind of number is this? So pi is called irrational number. So now we have come to another thing which is called irrational numbers. What kind of irrational numbers are? So before knowing to irrational numbers, we should know about real numbers. So what kind of numbers are real numbers? So real numbers are the numbers lying between this interval, minus infinity to infinity. Same thing is we have discussed here. What is infinity? Infinity is a very, very big number that I do not know. If I expect some number, means 100 to the power 100 to the power 100, is this infinity? No, infinity is greater than this. If I say 100 to the power 100 to the power 100 to the power 100 to the power 100, no, infinity is greater than this. So can I speak about this infinity? No, we cannot speak about infinity. Infinity is a very big number. Even you and me both cannot speak what kind of number is this. We can just imagine that this is a very big number which we can write like this, but its value I cannot write. And similarly, this minus infinity, so all the numbers lying from minus infinity, lying between minus infinity, between, why do I say between? Because they cannot be the extreme values. If I say from 1 to 7, means I am discussing about 1, 2, 3, like this. No, but extreme values cannot be taken. That is why I am using the word between. So numbers lying between minus infinity and infinity are called irrational numbers. So real numbers minus infinity to minus infinity and infinity, numbers lying between minus infinity and infinity are called real numbers. And in this series of real numbers, few numbers are rational and fewer those who are not rationals are called irrational numbers. What kind of numbers are they? Irrational numbers. So first of all, let's discuss more on rational numbers, more of rational numbers. So rational numbers are the numbers which can be written in the form of p by q, and they can be expressed in decimals. They can be expressed in decimals, but when we express them in decimals, then their decimal expansion should be, for example, if I use this 4/5, then what do we have? 4/5, if I divide this 4/5, then it is like 0.8. If I write 1/2, what is this? 0.5. And if I write 1/3, then this is 0.333 up to infinity. Then these numbers are called rational numbers. Why are they called rational numbers? Because result of this 4/5 is 0.8. It's over now. And result of this 1/2 is 0.5. And if I write 1/4, then it goes up to like this 0.25. 1/8 is what? 0.125, like this. So it gets terminated after certain terms. And if the number does not terminate like this is non-terminating number, non-terminating, but it is appearing again and again, 333. So such kind of numbers are called recurring numbers. But we can say that numbers, which kind of numbers are rational numbers? Those who gets terminated, who terminates, and if they do not terminate, they repeat like this. But if a number is like this, 2.01001001001, like this, means after decimal expansion, somewhere numbers are not repeating, means non-terminating and non-repeating. Here, if numbers are non-terminating, then they are repeating, recurring number. So these kind of numbers means what kind of numbers? Which are terminating and repeating are called rational numbers. So one more thing you will have to keep in mind, that these numbers, rational numbers, they are in the form of p by q, and their outcome is either terminating or repeating, terminating or repeating. These kind of numbers are called rational numbers. That is why 22/7, why is this? This is p and this is what? This is q. Both are integers, and they are in the form of p by q. Therefore this is a rational number. And when it comes to pi, when it comes to square root 2, square root 3, these numbers are called irrational numbers. So what kind of numbers are rational? Repeating or terminating, or you can say terminating or repeating, or which in the form of p by q. But to identify irrational numbers are non-repeating, non-terminating. So what kind of numbers are irrational numbers? Irrationals are non-terminating and non-repeating. Non-terminating and non-repeating. Non-terminating and non-repeating. These kind of numbers are called irrational numbers. These kind of numbers are called irrational numbers. And pi. Pi is a number whose value is 3.14 something something. You can see more on pi if you wish to see that its outcome is non-terminating, non-repeating. But what is this 22 by 7? 22 by 7 is its approx value. Its approx value. It is not exact value of pi, 22 by 7, because 22 by 7 is a rational number. And actual value of pi is an irrational number. So, let's come to conclude this through a mind map that all the numbers here real numbers, and in real numbers two sections are there. One is of rational and another is of irrational. In rational numbers, we have integers we have whole numbers. In whole numbers, we have natural numbers. And irrational numbers are the numbers which are non-terminating, non-repeating, and their examples are pi, root 2, root 3, root 4, no, not root 4, because root 4 is what? Plus minus 2, and root 7, like this. Then what is the concept here? Square root of prime number is always an irrational number. So, my dear students, in this video, we have discussed about the rational and irrational numbers. In next videos, I will be discussing more about rational numbers. So watch my next video. Wish you good luck.